Grüß euch Leute, herzlich willkommen zurück bei Let's Play That Dragon Cancer. Heute geht es weiter hier mit dem Kapitel oder der Szene, dem Abschnitt. I'm sorry guys, it's not good. Und von dem Titel glaube ich, wir werden heute die Erstdiagnose miterleben. Und da bin ich mal sehr gespannt, wenn das das richtige Wort ist. Okay.
Farmer Bill makes the pigs bacon for breakfast. Farmer Bill plays fetch with the pigs.
Oh. Die Sonne geht weiter in einen Sturm.
Farmer Bill enjoys a mud bath with the pigs. Farmer Bill scratches the pig's chinny chin chin.
Oh, die Sonne ist bei den Wolken angelangt.
Those mischievous pigs are napping on Farmer Bill's couch.
Oh, und gleich ist sie verschwunden.
The pigs wash the dishes after supper. Farmer Bill separates the sheep from the goats. Sheep go to heaven. Goats go to town.
I'm sorry, guys. It's not good.
Okay.
I'm sorry, guys. It's not good. I'm sorry, guys. It's not good.
Okay, ich glaube, hier geht's jetzt weniger darum.
I'm sorry, guys. It's not good.
Ich glaube, die Möglichkeit, das immer wieder anzuhören, ist es, weil das so ziemlich der eine Satz ist, der einem in so einem Fall wirklich in Erinnerung bleibt. Leider. Okay, können wir uns jetzt hier die Reaktionen der einzelnen Leute anschauen? Ich bin auf seine gespannt.
Size matters. How big is it? If I know how big it is, I can fix it. I can size it up.
And it's quite small at this point, but unfortunately the size isn't terribly important. Any recurrence means the chemotherapy has failed. This is a tragedy.
Okay, es ist nicht, wie ich angenommen hatte, die Erstdiagnose, sondern nach der Therapie, dass es weitergeht. Okay, und das ist jetzt hier Amy, die Mutter.
I guess I have imagined it. I've imagined it a lot, but not like this. It's different. I thought I would sob uncontrollably or puke just right on the floor. I thought I'd shake or wail or something. I guess this is shock. Tragedy, he said. That's right. That's the perfect word for this. It's a tragedy. I wonder if he says that every time. He's crying a little. I love him for that. He's not callous. He's genuinely sad. She is too.
So there just aren't any treatment options that are curative.
Okay, und jetzt, was sagt der Arzt, beziehungsweise was denkt der Arzt? Bin ich mal gespannt.
We're very good at end-of-life care. We're very good at managing the pain and masking symptoms at the end of life. How long are we talking about?
Prediction time again. No matter what I say, they'll wish it was longer. But sometimes longer is worse. A few weeks to maybe 4 months.
Das heißt jetzt, Joel ist jetzt 5 laut dem, oder? Also wenn das alles chronologisch einigermaßen hinhaut, von daher. Und ja, die Sonne zieht wieder in Richtung der Wolken.
Is Nick crying? How long are we talking about? How am I gonna hold it together now?
A few weeks to maybe 4 months.
Okay, gibt's jetzt noch andere? Andere Optionen hier? Andere Gedanken?
Oh, miracles are scary.
How long are we talking about?
A few weeks to maybe 4 months.
Oh, ich verstehe. Das hier ist die Zeitachse hier oben. Und jeder kann jetzt sich seinen Teil dazu denken, okay. Mir geht's hauptsächlich jetzt allerdings um die Eltern.
4 months. What is that? February? So we have Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's, Joel's birthday, maybe Valentine's Day? And that's it? And, ugh. We still haven't told anyone I'm pregnant. Too scared they'd think it was irresponsible. And now this? They'll think it's a replacement baby. I don't want a replacement.
Well, the radiation could probably kill the tumor we see now, which would prevent it from causing any symptoms. But it would not keep more tumors from developing. Because we know if it spread here, it would spread other places too.
So, the radiation would buy us some time.
No, nothing will really buy us any time at this point. It just can make the time you have left more comfortable. So, we'll schedule you to come back in Monday, and we'll have some options for you to consider. We're so sorry.
Und ja, der Regen. Der Regen ist da. Februar. Wenn sie 4 Monate, das heißt, es müsste sein. Oktober. 4 Monate ist nicht viel, vor allen Dingen, wenn man es weiß, ist es, glaube ich, schätzungsweise sogar noch ein bisschen schlimmer.
In the movie, I'd be kicking things and throwing chairs through windows. Amy would be sobbing and back against the wall, slowly falling to the ground. I should be yelling. Why am I not yelling?
Thank you. That means a lot.
You're welcome. Sorry, guys. It's not good.
The MRI?
They've always been clear. Joel's had a recurrence for the tumor. Where is it? How big is it?
Well, it's in the frontal cortex. And it's quite small at this point. But unfortunately, the size isn't terrible. Any recurrence means the chemotherapy is failed. This is a tragedy. With an ATRT, as soon as you have a recurrence of any kind, it is fatal. It is only a matter of time before it spreads to several locations. We have already thrown all the chemotherapy we have at it. We can't continue to use the chemotherapy that we know it resistant to. So there just aren't any treatment options that are curative.
Thank you. und wir sinken. Nein, wir sinken doch nicht. Vier Monate. Adrift. Oh, Moment, sind wir jetzt hier in einer Traumwelt oder was? Okay. Oh, und wir sind jetzt ein Vogel, wie wir hier daran sehen. Da hinten ist der Leuchtturm, der uns vielleicht Sicherheit gibt im Sturm der Gefühle. Ah, jetzt sind wir dieser Vogel. War da hinten auch einer? Ah, Joel und Amy.
Things stirring around in my spirit that I have to write to settle myself and find God's wisdom in the midst of chaos. I'm scared I won't be strong enough to face the things we might have to face in the coming weeks and months. But then I remember how much grace God gave us to walk out everything we've already faced. I've never felt completely overwhelmed, and I've never felt alone. So no matter what comes next, and I truly cannot even begin to guess how this will go, I know we will be carried. I want to shout out, look what God is about to do. Watch how he delivers Joel. And at the same time, I want to roll up in a silent ball and wait it out with fear and trembling, so aware of all my doubt, but yet convinced that my doubt is insignificant compared to God's faithfulness.
Also ganz ehrlich, in der Situation, Amy ist schwanger, hält ihr sterbendes Kind im Arm und die Gedanken dabei, das ist einfach fast unwirklich seltsam und nicht schon traurig, aber traurig ist dafür, glaube ich, nicht einmal das richtige Wort.
Chicken stuffed in his cheeks from dinner.
Wow, that is so disgusting.
Been in there for the last 2 hours. Okay, hold on, I'm trying. Joel, ouch! Stop!
Did he just bite you?
I think he like just put too much in his mouth so he can't swallow.
He was just saving it for later, babe. Like he needed a midnight snack.
He's a little chipmunk.
Okay.
A bigger version.
A big version of a little chipmunk. Do you guys remember when he couldn't even eat any solids and he couldn't swallow? Do you remember that from the surgery how it hurt his ability to swallow, so we had to give him bottles.
Yeah, I remember one time we had pizza, so he chewed it all up and then spat it out everywhere.
That's so
gross. What? I remember that. That was so gross. But he just wanted to try things so bad. He wanted to taste them. He wanted to be like you guys. Because you got to taste foods. He loved to eat, and I remember all I wanted was for him to be able to kind of eat like a normal kid and have normal things. I thought he'd never be able to swallow normal food. But then he did.
And now he's everything.
Everything. Like, he eats pizza and pretzels and chicken.
And fingers.
He tried to eat his dad's fingers.
Ow, Joe!
Okay.
And penguins.
Okay. Settle down. Come here. Let's sing a song. Okay. What should we sing, Isaac?
Let me go.
Okay.
I like it.
Hey. You guys, I love to have fun with you.
I'm trying to get the little stars.
But at bedtime, every time. Elijah, lay down.
Ich hätte mir das da vorne vielleicht noch fertig anhören können, aber ich bin gerade zu gespannt, was das hier wieder ist. Es ist wahrscheinlich wieder ein Gedanke von Amy.
We've been through so much already. This is a new degree of tragedy, but it's not so much different from the struggle we've already been living. We pressed into God. We pressed into faith. We fought until we found peace. We stood in peace when our flesh wanted to strive more. We stood in peace when it started to feel like laziness or foolishness or both. We waited for God to direct us specifically in prayer because all the directions we had initiated had not panned out. We prayed for no nausea because that's what we felt in our spirits we were supposed to pray, even though we'd prayed it countless times before while Joel continued to vomit. We saw one small miracle and then another. We waited to pray specific things until we were given specific direction, and we saw bigger miracles. And yet, if you asked either of us if we were doing enough, trying hard enough, we would say no.
Das Gefühl muss unvorstellbar schlimm sein, wenn man sich den Vorwurf macht, nicht genug zu tun, getan zu haben in dieser Situation.
Dear Eli, I feel nothing but pride for the way you battled cancer. I remember the way you learned to ride your tricycle down the hospital hallway instead of down the sidewalk like other three-year-olds. It was hard for me to pray to God, "Thy will be done," when I really just wanted so desperately for Him to heal you. In the 4.5 years that you dealt with harsh treatments, only once did you ask why God let you get cancer. I hope He has been able to explain the why to you, as I have always believed that He knew how strong you were and wanted to use you and your situation to positively impact so many lives. I remember how you never let me go to bed without telling me that you loved me and how those were your very last words to me. You taught me what was truly important in life, son. Still now, years after you left Earth, people are impacted by your life and the lessons you taught us. Thousands of people from around the world read your blog and still feel such a strong connection to you, even though they never met you in person.
Das ist alles so unwirklich. Es geht mir gerade wirklich auch sehr an die Substanz, also tut mir leid, wenn ich jetzt nicht großartig was Tolles dazu sage, aber...
So, how long will we be in California?
I don't actually know. That's kind of why we're packing up everything, is because if the trial works really well, then maybe we'll stay in California for a really long time. Like, as long as it keeps helping Joel, then we want to stay and do the best we can for him and stay there where he's getting help. But if the medicine starts to not work, as soon as it's not helping him, I promise we'll come back home.
Are we going to Disneyland?
Yeah, of course. What do you think, Caleb? You okay with leaving for so long?
I'm kind of excited, but I'm kind of not. I mean, I think it'll be fun, but I just don't like missing school.
Oh, yeah?
You're the only 8-year-old to ever. That's amazing.
I hate to miss school, huh? But, like, why?
Well, I just hate having all that homework that I have to do.
Oh, you hate catching up from missing school.
Your teachers are going to send me homework, and we'll just try to do a little bit of it every day, so it won't be that bad, but there'll still be fun stuff we can
do. How many kids get to go and go on an adventure to California in the middle of the school year? I'd say that's pretty cool. And we're going to be staying in the middle of San Francisco near Golden Gate Park, and there's a museum, and there's a botanic garden, and there's the Golden Gate Bridge, and water, and a prison, and I promise not to leave you in the prison.
Alcatraz.
Hopefully we can get out of that. Cool. Anyway, so we're going to have lots of fun, and we're going to spend lots of time as a family together, and lots of time with Joel, too. You know?
Yeah.
It's kind of a sad trip, even though it's fun. Yay.
Yeah. Yay and sad. It's kind of all of those things, huh? Is it all the things, Caleb?
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to see Joel, you know, like, needing so much help.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think, like, for me, sometimes I'm kind of excited, and sometimes I'm kind of sad, and I just kind of feel all of that. So it's okay if you guys feel all of that, too, because I feel all those things.
Oh, da unten haben wir sogar noch etwas. Da hinten auch, oder? Aber gut, ich muss diese Folge dann auch langsam mal beenden, weil ich kann hier nicht da jetzt eine halbe Stunde machen. Ganz einfach, weil dann werde ich gar nichts mehr sagen, dann werde ich nur noch weinen und ich glaube, dass ist auch nicht genau das, was ihr wollt. Wobei, vielleicht schon. Wir sehen uns dann auf jeden Fall beim nächsten Mal an genau dieser Stelle wieder, wenn wir hier weitere Gedanken, weitere Erinnerungen der Familie und grundsätzlich mehr über Joels weiteren Vorgang in den möglicherweise letzten 4 Monaten dann erfahren. Ja. Bis zum nächsten Mal bei That Dragon Cancer. Und bis dahin sage ich Tschüss, Leute.